Good evening, all Atmas. Today we are going to discuss on Bhagavad Gita, Jnana Yajna. In that, we are continuing with Chapter 2, Communion Through Knowledge. Today's sloka is relating to Jnana Yoga having impact on the work which one has to do without attachment. This Lord Krishna explains to Arjuna to make him to take his Astasastra to fulfill his duties. So in order to make him to do that by realizing the truth about the Jnana, he tells this to Arjuna. Mere action done with attachment is far inferior to action done with the mind poised in evenness. Mere action done with attachment. So, any action we do, it should not be done with attachment. Attachment leads to expectations. Expectations leads to desires. So, desire, there is no end for desire for man. In this Maya world, so one desire after another comes, it's mainly because of the attachment. So one should not have action. So that's why you say, mere action done with attachment is far inferior to action done with mind poised in evenness. Mind poised in evenness means what? At all times, mind should be in a state of sthita prajna. Whatever comes, accept, whatever goes, accept. Because that comes to know, that comes to only those who have the jnana, experience of our very purpose of the birth. See, our birth is based on Newton's third law of motion, law of conservation of energy, this has already been told. For every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. We have already done certain actions from our previous life, which we are bringing in the karma account. We have already spent energy for doing this action. We are going to take back that energy by facing the reaction. That is the truth. When this truth is known, so each and every moment in our life is nothing but whatever actions done, we are facing the reaction. So when this reaction, how we face when we are while doing our duties? These duties to whom we'll do? To ourselves, in getting educated, in getting employment, and achieving success in employment. And by doing that, what is that you are going to earn? You are going to earn money. That money, what you are going to do? You do your duties towards the other souls with whom you got bonded. And through this bondage, you come across various events in life. Suppose your mother is not well, you will take to hospital, spend the money for that. Your children met with an accident, you have to take them to hospitals and give the treatment. All this you have to, for which money is needed, you are earning, and this you are spending. By spending to the souls with whom you are bonded, a situation is arising for you to release the karmas. And through this only you release the karmas. If you know the truth, then you will not get attached to this. If you don't know the truth, you get attached and you get dejected. Seek shelter in the state of unperturbed evenness of mind, which can arise only in a desireless mind in communion with the divine. That is, so always we should seek shelter. That is, mind should be seek shelter in this state of unperturbed evenness of mind. The mind should always be in a state of unperturbed evenness. That is, buddhi should be taken to the Atma and divine consciousness. That's why he says, which can arise only in a desireless mind in communion with divine. Desireless mind in communion with, means you should not have any desires. Whatever comes, accept, whatever goes, accept. The second you are supposed to do some act, you do it without any desire. Because that even what you are facing is sent by God. It's a God sent to release your karma. That's why always you should keep your buddhi in Atma and divine consciousness. Then only the mind will be in a sthita prajna. So, In this respect, I want to give a small anecdote. Instance. There was a farmer in a village. He had about 10 cows. So he used to daily morning milk the cows and he sent to the forest. Then nearby the mountain, there was greenery and always all the cows, after milking the cows, when it leaves, it goes to the greenery there near the mountains. It will there up to evening and then it will come automatically back home. This is normal practice in most of the villages where the farmers used to do. So all the cows, each cow gives about 4 liters, 5 liters milk, very, very healthy cows. So one day what happens, these 10 cows, they go and graze the, near the mountain. In the evening, one day, out of 10 cows, 9 cows returns, one didn't return. He waits and see why one cow has not returned. So in the evening, late night it happens, then he goes and see near the mountain. Then he couldn't find the cow. So he searched nearby all the places and he asked the village people, have you seen the cow? No, they have not seen the cow. Then he went and complained to the police that one cow was lost. Okay, this farmer is a person who adopts this jnana theory, unprompted awareness of mind. So after giving the complaint, he comes back. That is his duty he has done. He lost the cow, so he went to, he verified with all the villagers. When everybody said we don't know, then he went to the police station, gave the complaint and come back. And he came back and was sitting in the veranda outside and thinking what to do next, tomorrow. Because his focus is only on his duties. Whatever comes, accept, whatever goes, accept is the principle. So what happens when he was thinking at that time, villagers come. What happened, Raghu, did you know anything about the cow? No, I checked everywhere, there is nobody says we are not seen it. And I gave the complaint. So when everybody came and inquired about the cow, he has lost the cow, everybody felt bad and they came there to console him. But he was quite calm, normal. He didn't get excited or dejected for having lost the cow, because the cow is very costly, about 30,000 cost. Okay. Because he is the man having this unperturbed evenness of mind. That maturity of mind he did. So whomsoever I come, Atithi Deva Bhava, for all the people, he asked his wife to give coffee to them, everybody. What is this? We came here to console you. You'll be feeling bad, you'll feel dejected, that's why we came here to console you. But you are remaining calm. What to do? Thing had to happen. Okay, but what next we have to see? So I was thinking what to do. Tomorrow morning I have to give 20 liters of milk to the hotel. These 5 liters are getting short because of this cow. So, whether I get or not, I have to proceed, I have to carry on with my duties, no. I have to fulfill my duties as a farmer and other things. So he said, okay, tomorrow afternoon I am going to market and buy a cow. But in the morning to give milk to the hotel, I request you some people to give some milk. What is that? I will give. So everybody collects milk from one person. In the morning, 5 liters milk, and after making the 9 cows, he sends the 9 cows back. And with 10 liters, he fulfills his commitment to the hotel. And then in the afternoon, he went to market with the saved money, he buys another cow. And again with 10 cows, he starts his life. So it goes on normally. So for having lost, he didn't get dejected or excited or felt self-anger on himself. Okay, this will happen, let it happen. Whatever comes, accept, whatever goes, accept. That is the principle he follows. Then after 6 months, or about 1 year, what happens? No? One day, the normal 10 cows came. Subsequently, he found one cow came near his house and shouted, Ma, And he came out and said, the World Cup which has lost, no, 1 year back, that came. It came along with the his calf, which is also a female. That also in the stage of giving milk. So that it has gone a wrong path, met with a male, and it gave birth to a calf, and now it identified the, it joined with the balance 9 cows in the mountain, and it now it come along with that. So villagers came to know, then everybody came, aha, you are a lucky man, then you have got the last cow, along with that you had a calf which is also going to come in, which is going to give milk in a short period, so you are a lucky man. Now he has got gain, because already 10 cows is there, now another 2 cows is getting, is going to get more milk, that means more income. Everybody felt, first initially they felt, they came to console him. Now since he got 2 additional cows, now they felt jealous on him. You are a lucky man, yeah, you are going to get additional 10 liters extra, so you are going to make a good income, you are great, yeah. That they, by telling, praising, they feel jealous on him. He remains okay. He used coffee to them and then sent. He remains calm because whether initially he lost, he remained calm. Now, addition, last he gained, then he remains calm. After some time, what happens during that golden days, there will be when the war is there, war night. There is a king come that way. When his horses, when his cows were grazing, grazing in the mountain, he found one white cow of his. So he wanted to take for this yajna. So he comes and asks the farmer to give that. Instead, he gives one horse and money for buying 2 cows. So he took the money. Because king asks means yes, he can't say no. He gave it. Then villagers come. Oh, you are great, yeah. King came and asked you one cow and gave one horse, and also along with that he gave money for buying 2 cows. So they feel jealous. He feel, okay, I have done my duty. He remained calm. What happens? You get the horse, no. So since he one cow has gone, he, with the money given by king, he went to buy the cow in the market. So when he just left for the market, his son, what he took the horse, and without knowing how to ride the horse, he take the horse, and he get fell down and broke his legs. And the villagers run and tell him, your son took the horse and got his legs broken. So immediately rush back and take his son to hospital. His son got afraid, oh, father will be scolding me, because I have done mistake without his knowledge, without knowing, without having proper training, I have taken the horse and I got this. So he is having the pain. He felt he had fear of his father. He may scold him or he may beat him. The father, seeing his son suffering from pain, he took him to the hospital and got that fracture. He took X-ray and spent money to get the fracture completed. Said, "Don't worry, it will be clear." So after admitting him, then he goes with the dog. Raja, king gave money for 2, he spent one for his son and another for buying a cow. So he knows this is the stage, his son is going to face this event and he has to suffer because of the pain, and by that he is releasing his karma, and by doing my duty as a father to my son, taking to hospital and getting admitted to him, I am releasing my karma. This is the truth he realized. That's why he didn't get perturbed. He remains calm. Oh, that's all. And he does his duty by showing all the love and affection to his son, so that he don't feel that fear. He feel keep calm so that he don't have that pain also. So that's why he does his duty. So at that time the villagers come. They console, oh, what a mishap happened because of the king gave a horse that has led to you suffer, your son to suffer pain, and you have to spend money on his hospitalization, all this. Okay, he says, he gave them coffee and sent them. Because he knows at this juncture what is happening is this horse coming, king coming and asking his cow, and he is giving the horse and giving money for buying the cow. All these are part of release of karma. Each and every event is happening according to his decision. He has already destined what is to happen. Then what to worry about? Why to worry about? Let me just accept it. Whatever comes, accept. Whatever do, I have to do, let me do it. He remains unperturbed at all the situations. That's why he didn't felt suffer loss in taking the hospitalization and thing. He showed all his love and affection to the child. Remain calm. Then one day what happened? War came at that time. All the youngsters in the family, one young person from the family should participate in the war. So king gave direction to give youth from each family to come for war. So the village, all the youth have been taken. When the general comes and sees this boy got fractured. He says, okay, you are not fit to participate in the war. He leaves and goes. Other time villagers come. Yeah, this accident was a blessing in disguise for your son. Because you have saved your son from going to war. We don't know what our children are going to war, whether they come back alive or dead, I don't know. So by this accident was a good thing has happened for you. They feel jealous. He said, okay, left it behind. He said, okay, whatever accident, come. So what this story tells about is this farmer who is having this knowledge of unperturbed evenness of mind at all situations. It's because he didn't have any desire. He's having a desireless mind communing with the divine. Because always communicating is with the in a divine conscious level. He was just carrying on his samsaric life only. As a farmer, he's doing his duty to his five children. He's doing duty as a supplier of milk to the hotel. He respects all the villagers. Everything, whatever duty he is doing, without unperturbedness of mind, he just carries on. Because when his son get fractured, he didn't scold, you waste. If other man is there, who is again, what will he do? He will beat his son. You have unnecessarily make me to spend money unnecessarily because of your bad action. He would have scolded, but this man remained calm. This is the situation. In this situation, he is releasing his karma. And by taking him to hospital and spending money, I am releasing my karma. So there is nothing. I have neither to gain nor to lose. Let me remain always an unperturbed evenness of mind. And that is the situation. And that makes him to realize. That's why one should always remain in a desireless state while carrying on these samsaric duties. This Bhagavad Gita, each and every sloka, what is explained here, is purely applicable to us in our family life. Because I told you, the war is nothing but our life is the war, where all the people who are aiming arrow on us are nothing but our own family members, our the souls with whom we are bonded in our life. One who come along with us till our last breath, some people come and go, like a milkman. Whomsoever it may concern. So neighbors, once in a while they come and go. Like that, our association with various kinds of people in the society and the family, whomsoever it may concern, whatsoever they do, at a particular event, particular moment, something is happening. Some event happens means it is nothing but release of karma. This is the sthita prajna stage one should attain. And that is being explained here. Instead, those who work for selfish gains are indeed pitiable, because one who does, they forget that they are coming with all this karma. Everything they didn't bother about all. So they have only the vision, because they keep when the person who is keeping the buddhi in the sensual conscious mind, whatever sees, he get attracted. The attraction leads to desires, and he goes towards fulfilling his desires. Desire, there is no end. One desire, if he fulfills, another desire comes. So he is going after the desires and work all tirelessly to satisfy his desires, unquenched desires, and some desires he fulfills, he gets a happiness. Some desires we don't feel, he will anger, jealousy, hatred and rejections, all these things it comes to. So we have to feel pity, because if he feels excited or dejection, everything he accumulates karma only. So one should not have that kind. Then should lead a desireless in communion with the divine. Always keep the buddhi in the divine consciousness while doing your duties, so that you release all the karmas and lead a contented, peaceful life. That is what needed for our success. So this is about this sloka. We will see the next sloka in the session.